your favorite book?
My favorite book is it's called The Perks of Being a Wallflower.
Okay, who's that by?
It's like Stephen Chbosky, something like that.
Okay, I never read that. I may have to check that out.
That's
Shani, what's your favorite book?
I don't really read books.
You don't read books?
No.
You in seventh grade, you don't read books?
No.
All right, okay, what's your favorite movie?
Freedom Riders.
Freedom Riders, okay. I like that movie. One thing that people don't realize that books and movies have in common is that if you read a book with your imagination like you're supposed to, it should be like watching a movie in your head. They use character traits to identify the different characters. You paint a picture and boom, there it is. So, trait. Can anybody define the word trait? Okay, Shani.
Like a personality.
All right, yeah. Personality traits. Okay. Brandy, do you have a different definition?
Just like a component of yourself.
Right, a component of yourself. So what are some, I guess, personality traits or components we can use to describe you guys? Or me, let's do me. Okay, boom. Y'all describe me. Describe Miss B.
Generous.
Generous, okay.
I was gonna say kind. That was
kind. Okay. I'm working with a little something. Okay, what if y'all give me one more?
Smart.
Smart? I like that one. I like that one. Okay. Okay, it's okay.
Silly.
Silly? Oh, okay. All right, so why would we say I'm generous? Because we just can't say I'm generous the way we could say I have long hair, or that I have light skin, or that I'm skinny. So why do you say I'm generous?
Based on things that you do.
Right.
How you treat us.
Right. Okay, so we can also see in books that in the beginning, like when we're in elementary school, books are easier to read because I guess authors just give things away. So say we're reading a book, okay, the character's name is Danny. She'll be like, Danny is sad. Danny is happy. Danny is, you know, she just gives it away. But now we're reading books like Esperanza Rising, it could be kind of harder to figure out what's going on. So we have to look at what the characters are doing to know who the characters are or why they do certain things. So basically, action is character. It's also like, I guess, when you meet people, sometimes they tell you about themselves. But when you get to know them, they can, you know, kind of differ from what they told you. Like, what's some examples of people, things people always say that end up not being true?
They loyal.
They loyal.
From forever.
I'm real. What's that one?
Because
that's the main one. It's hard to think after that one.
They got money. They know.
Yeah. They got money, or that they're nice. Like they're, you know, a good friend. Yeah. But later, when you see their actions, it's like they're not even this person. Action is character. Okay, so the same way we just described me is the same way we analyze characters in literature. So sometimes when we have to answer certain questions or write certain essays, this is how we would talk about the book or the characters or even understand the book. So let's think of a story that everybody knows. Okay. Jeanette, you pick one.
Cinderella.
Cinderella, okay, yeah, that's perfect. Okay, so I have an activity for you guys. Everybody pick a character from Cinderella and do a short analysis on that character, all right? Talk about, I guess, list character traits and then analyze. Okay, so who's ready to share their analysis with the class? Don't be scared, it's just practice.
I chose Cinderella because she's very kind-hearted, optimistic, and helpful.
Well, I chose Cinderella too, but I kind of like thought differently about her. I thought that she was caring, and I definitely thought she was optimistic. She had like big dreams and stuff. But at the same time, I just felt like she was so dependent on everyone else. Like, she couldn't do anything by herself.
Right. Shani, what did you think?
I think Cinderella was selfless because even though people were so mean to her, she still was nice to them and did what she had to do.
All right. Those are all very good answers. Right. Action is character. So, who knows this beat? Come on, do it. I know y'all recognize it. Now say, action is character.
Action is character.